Hey! Hey, you here! And what the heck was that? Looks like our Falcon 9 turned into kind of a spinny boy there. Well, Hayu explains. Today was the launch of SpaceX's Commercial Resupply 16 on behalf of NASA to send supplies to the ISS. This launch comes just 2 days after the SSOA launch by SpaceX, which was actually the first time they launched a single booster 3 times. That thing was looking pretty toasty. Anyway, while the mission today was completely successful, and Dragon, the spacecraft, it's on its way to the ISS as we speak, something went a little bit weird. For the Falcon 9 rocket, there is almost always a secondary mission, which is to land the booster either back onto land or onto a platform at sea in order to recover it for future missions. In order to make it back to the launch site after deploying the second stage, the Falcon 9 first stage booster turns around, slows itself down to a stop, and then starts coming backwards to the launch site. After lighting its engines to slow down before re-entry, it then deploys its grid fins, which are like wings except waffle irons, and these help it guide itself through the atmospheric portion of its descent. It's managed to do pretty well controlling itself like an airplane up until this point, but what apparently happened, according to company founder Elon Musk, is the hydraulic pump controlling all of the grid fins stalled, i.e. stopped working, causing the grid fins to kind of not work correctly and stick in places, and basically made the whole thing start spinning. What you can see here is the guidance computer realizing there was an error, and then correcting so that the booster does not go toward land. It's common practice for boosters to always be aiming for the ocean until they know that their trajectory is correct, and then they start to go toward either the land or the platform they're going to land on. This is a safety measure to make sure they don't, you know, basically fall like a missile. Now, as it approached the water, it still conducted its landing burn normally. They do this because even though it was a failed landing, they really want to test everything as many times as they can to get data so they can make it more reliable in the future, especially for human missions like landing on Mars. During the landing burn, the engines are slowing down the rocket so it can land, while also steering the rocket so it doesn't fall over. And this was an incredibly impressive maneuver today. It was coming in at this ridiculous angle, and the engines corrected everything. It landed on the water just fine, so fine in fact, that when it tipped over, it just kind of slowly, softly landed in the water. Usually when rockets hit the water, they hit it like concrete and they just explode. Elon has since stated on Twitter that they will try and reuse this rocket again, despite the water landing, for one of their internal satellite launches, which will be for their future internet constellation, Starlink. I won't get too into the details now, but Starlink is a future project which they'll start next year. They've already sent up test satellites, but what it is a huge constellation of 4,000 or so satellites around the Earth that are all very small and very low down, so that if you want to have internet from these satellites, it will be incredibly fast compared to previous satellite internet where the satellites are really far away. These spacecraft will be barely skimming the atmosphere using electric propulsion to counteract the drag from the air, which means that if anything goes wrong with them, they won't create space junk, they'll just fall straight down. Anyway, it's wonderful that this mission was still a success and that Dragon is on its way to the ISS to deliver all those wonderful science-y payloads. If you want to make sure you catch footage of that landing once they post it, do follow SpaceX on Twitter, or follow me on Twitter, I'll totally retweet it. Other than that, I highly recommend you subscribe to the SpaceX subreddit if you haven't already. It's a fan community and they have so much rocket science they will teach you, oh my god. And if you want to discuss more rocket science, go over to my Patreon. We have a link to our Discord server, and we're all mostly friendly. We play a lot of Minecraft together. Anyway, do leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. This has been Hayu. Bye!